There's a big difference between using clip gain for level changes and using the channel fader. I'll show some examples that make that very clear, but first, the easiest way to understand it is to have a quick look at the signal flow in Cubase. I have this audio, which is the signal, and this event is the starting point of my signal flow. The first thing we can do to it is the initial gain staging. You can use clip gain for that, with the fader, or like this, or clip gain automation with the draw tool, or with audio segment detection. Or you can have the pre-section in the mix console and do it there. So this clip gain and this gain here are two ways to change the gain, which is the level of the audio, in the first stage of the signal flow. After that, the signal goes to the insert section. More specifically, it flows from the top plugin to the bottom one. So the effect you use here gets carried over to here, you add some more stuff, that all goes to the next one, and so on and so on. And if you want to use them in a different order, you can just drag them. You might have noticed that these are labeled pre as well. In this case, that means pre-channel fader, but I'll get back to that. Next, it goes to the channel strip, but if you want to go from channel strip to inserts, you can make them switch places by clicking here. Here, the signal flows from left to right, and you can also drag these to put them in a different order. And after that, you can send sort of a copy of the signal with all the processing up to this point to different places. Effects tracks would be the most common destination. Then the signal goes to the channel fader. By the way, if you use volume automation in the automation lane, you're automating this fader. Now let's go back to the sends for a second because that one's a bit tricky. Visually, you see the send before the channel fader, but by default, the sends actually branch off of the signal that comes out of the fader. So they are post-fader sends. If you want to send the signal before it hits the fader, you turn the send into a pre-fader send. And I'll link to a couple of videos if you want to know more about the pre- and post-fader sends. Next, let's go back to the inserts. Remember these ones said pre from pre-fader? Well, if you go below the green line, and you can also move that, you can insert post-fader plugins. But those are more so for mastering purposes, so you can just stick to the pre-inserts. And after all that, the signal goes to the stereo output, which goes to your speakers. But if you want it to go to more places, or if you want to alternate between outputs, you can use direct routing. That has many uses, one of them being easy and flexible stem exports. Alright, I have some compression on this track to show the difference between clip gain or pre-gain and the channel fader. This is what it sounds like. The right amount of compression, and when I turn the channel fader up, the whole thing got louder, but the compression is still the same. If, however, I would change the clip gain, I could also do the pre-gain, same thing. Now the compression is messed up because it's getting a way louder input. So changing clip gain or pre-gain after you've added processing is a no-go. Or you'd have to go into every plugin and redo the settings. And one more example of how to use clip gain or pre-gain. When you're starting a mix, not only do you want to leave a good amount of headroom for every track, but you might also want to keep your main faders at unity gain, which is zero. So before you start mixing, you can do the gain staging here for every track. You can also find the pre-section here, by the way. And while you're mixing, you're going to use the main faders, which are now in a perfect spot. Because imagine if I used these for gain staging, it might have ended up down here. Now the smallest movement is a 10 decibel change. While up here I have all this room for just 5 decibels, so it's way easier to make precise changes. That's why they say there's a higher resolution around unity gain.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe, and have fun making music.